around us are lovely people, and we are here for a beautiful purpose today. We're here for a happy reason, gathered in the presence of God, of family, of friends, to join Chinda and David in marriage. Marriage is for the well-being, happiness, and security of all of us. Beyond all the books written and advice given, the gift inside marriage is that each of us may be safe, may have a safe place where we can rest, dream, suffer, heal, laugh, and find delight, all in safety in the haven. Marriage is a gift for all cultures, all religions, all backgrounds. It's one of the institutions that crosses all boundaries. It allows children to be nurtured and loved to grow. Now, you are both young. David, you are in the prime of your strength. And Chinda, you are at the height of your loveliness. When we are young, we want each other. And when we grow old, we need each other. And both of those things are beautiful. Marriage is to be held in honor and high regard. So we're going to begin with your statements of intention about why you're here today. So I ask this question. Do you, David, take Chinda to be your wife? This is the first time I've done a wedding where I'm related. The first time. To cherish her in friendship and love today, tomorrow, and for as long as the two of you live. To trust and honor her, to love her faithfully through the best and the worst, whatever may come. And if you should ever doubt, to remember your love for her and the reason why you came together with her this day. Do you, Chinda, take David to be your husband, to cherish him in friendship and love today, tomorrow, and for as long as the two of you live, to trust and honor him, to love him faithfully through the best and the worst, whatever may come, and if you should ever doubt, to remember your love for him and the reason why you came together with him this day. So this is a selection from scripture that they chose. It's a famous one, often read at weddings. It's from 1 Corinthians 13, the writings of the Apostle Paul. It's not written for a wedding, but it certainly fits. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Now, I know we have different traditions here. And so I'm going to share a couple of stories from the Bible. And some in this room reverence Jesus as a Lord, as a deity, and others would honor him at least as a great teacher. So these are fitting to share today. Jesus told a story, and he told a story about two people who built a house, just like you're about to do. They started from the ground up, and they were going to build a home where there would be a family, a union, building a house, just like you two are just now starting out to build everything that your future will be together. Anybody walking by would have said there are two beautiful homes just alike. But then, this is what the story says, but then the rain came down, and the flood waters began to rise, and the wind began to blow, and one of the houses fell down, and one of them stood firm. And the difference wasn't in the house. The difference was in the foundation.
sing some of that recently about this.
Just don't look like a sea bass.
Didn't look like sea bass.
Hi, home. Hello. Hi.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we're going to go ahead and do the couple's first dance. I'd like to read a couple things to you in reference to the song. The dance is called... This time they're going to go ahead and do a couple pictures before it gets dark outside and the rain's not raining. They're going to do that real quick, then they're going to come back. At this time, you're welcome to the dessert bar while they're taking those pictures. Please help yourself to the dessert bar once the bar is open as well. Enjoy. Once they get back from pictures, we'll do the reverse dance. Thank you.
Yeah.